So here with Dan from DPW, how's it going?
Oh, good, thanks.
Yeah, we were talking about these modules before the show. Some serious wave shaping and distortion going on. Should we start with the distortion, maybe?
Yeah, so what I have set up here is kind of a piano sound or something. So just a clean, some kind of piano-like sound. And if I turn on the distortion, it's made to be playable depending on how hard you hit it and so on.
Sounds very responsive to dynamics.
Yeah, it's designed for guitar and bass, and as a guitar player I like when you can affect every tone with your fingers, so that's one of the hard things with designing distortions. And then it's divided in four bands. Because you usually get the problem with it, if you distort, especially bass, that it clogs up in low, mid-range, and you lose the low end and you lose the transients. So instead of doing a normal bypass, as a bypass in a way you can see it, I added a low band that is distorting in the same way as the. So you have the low mid, where you have the normal distortion. And the really low, that is handling the super low. The high, this one, is where you have more or less the transients. And then you have some kind of a coloration in between in the high mid band. So,
Right next to it, we've got what would be familiar maybe to a producer as opposed to a synthesist.
Yeah, but can I say one more thing about the distortion? Because what I've added to it is clickless switching on and off.
Okay.
So that is a cool thing in a way. So if I add... So this, you can hear when it's go on, you don't have any glitches. And that is because I added some kind of intelligent switching. So okay. It waits, there's two ways of getting clickless. You could do it by switching slow, or you switch super fast, but at exactly the right moment.
On zero crossings in the wave, is that what it detects? Or?
No.
Okay.
that is what you would think. But what it is doing, it's waiting in between one microsecond up to 50 milliseconds until both waves have the exact same potential, and then you switch really fast.
Okay.
Yeah, so in that way, you don't get any clicks. And the cool extra thing with that is if you go audio rate switching, that is unsynced with the incoming material, you can get it to go... It starts skipping switches, switching on some of the periods in the wave, and it gets really dirty and...
Sounds almost like a phase lock loop kind of sound. I don't know if the technology is the same.
No, absolutely not.
Kind of similar-ish in tone, maybe, but...
Yeah. But it's a new thing, yeah.
It's an interesting technology. That have you other ideas for that technology for the switching? Or
I have, but we can talk about that.
They're just ideas at this stage.
Yeah.
But so right to the right of the distortion, again, something familiar for maybe producers, studio musicians, or engineers. Compression, tail, transient. It seems very transient designer, compressor like.
It is kind of an odd take on that. Yes. And I've during the days I got questions about if anything is digital, and all this is analog. So what it's doing, if I have a really boring but cymbal thing going into it, this is a clean signal, And then you have a compressed signal that could be a little bit compressed up to, this is 10 times compressed, but still fairly transparent. It is more or less the same technology as in my limit module. And then if you listen to the tails, the transients, you can trim them in. So you have more or less just the transient material. And this is the incoming. And then you have the tails, which is just the washy parts of that thing. And
it's going to be amazing for coloring kind of whole synth voices and drums within the system.
Yeah, it works really well on complex material like wavetables and FM and so on. Because if you just use it to mangle the waves in that way, you will get something that is like a distortion, but the other way around. So instead of getting really squashed and compressed, you get something that is airy, but you will see it later.
Those that have played with transient shapers and things may be familiar.
Yeah.
So how far off are these from release?
Well, the four-band distortion, that is done. So I just have to go home and take away a patch and then run it through production. So a little over a month, I would say.
What's the price on that one?
I would guess it. I haven't quite calculated it yet, but it will be about 250 euros, I guess. Okay. And the shape, I just got it 3 days before I...
yeah.
Yeah, and I did the last solderings 2 hours before I went to the airplane. I would like to have it to play around with it for first. So to see if I should add or change
something. You're really onto something with that type of control and shaping in a Eurorack system.
Oh, thanks. It's one of those stupid ideas.
Well, it isn't.
This is one of the reasons.
Proof
why,
of concept.
Yeah, this is why I do this. It's like my wave folder is completely wrong from a wave folder perspective. It's more like a West Coast additive synth thing. I get these ideas and it's just me, so no one stops me and I build them. It's the best.
Oh, well, great. And people should follow you on, of course, Facebook, your website. I think that's going to be really special.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
Okay. Thanks.